Zack, zack. Let's do this. All right. Close these bloody doors.
This is the latest incarnation of the Mercedes G-Wagon. And once again, they've made an exceptional piece of machinery with exceptional figures to prove it.
...585 horsepowers, 850 newton meters of torque coming from a 4-liter twin turbocharged V8 up front. This car weighs 2.5 tons, and Mercedes still gets it to go to 100 k's an hour in only 4.5 seconds. How do they do that? If you keep your foot buried in the carpet, you'll reach a limited 220. Pay a bit more for the driver's package, and you'll get 240. But this is not the star of our show today. No, no. It's merely the way we're gonna get there.
This is Black Hole, a private collection with more than 20 cars that'll make out the cream of any petrolhead's dream. Here we have the Mercedes-Benz GTR Roadster, developing 585 horsepowers, one of only 750 in the world. And then one of our cars, the Novitec Rolls-Royce Wraith Black Badge Edition. Gosh, that's quite a mouthful. A stunning black Rolls coupe with an upgraded power output of 640 horses. We've also done some optical changes to the Rolls' bodyworks, including the rims and a lowered sport suspension. Then there's this, the McLaren 675LT with, as you can guess, 675 horsepowers. This is one of only 500 in the entire world. And we could go on for hours talking about the McLaren Senna GTR or the Mercedes SLS Black Series. This house is then filled with all things flat and fast. But we're not here to drive the fastest car on the planet, nor the sportiest. Nope. We're here to collect something that'll make our G-Class out in the parking lot look a little bit like a high school wannabe.
I came from the mud, there's dirt on my hands. Strong like a tree, there's roots where I stand. Oh, I've been running from the law. Hope they won't shoot me down soon.
This is the Mercedes-Benz G63 AMG 6x6. And as a machine, it's a far greater mouthful than its nomenclature suffices to suggest. Which is why we've summoned it to one of the most challenging tasks of its lifetime. To go get some marshmallows for dinner, with a little detour. But I had a little problem.
Hi, how's it going? Right, that's a bit embarrassing, driving with a handbrake up. This is not the first 6x6 Mercedes ever built. It actually has its origin as a military vehicle. And then that sort of spawned the idea for Mercedes to make a modern day version, which said, is not scared of what its military brother can do.
This G, modern or not, can do just about anything. Now let's start with the suspension and the drivetrain. Modern day 4x4s can wade through water about half a meter deep. The 6x6 easily does double that, thanks to its portal axles, the same they use in the Unimogs. Drive is sent to all six wheels via five different electronic diff lock possibilities at the flick of a switch. Now the 6x6 has a little trick up its sleeve when it comes to soft terrain. You can deflate all six wheels simultaneously. Drive through somebody's garden and then, if you like, you can inflate all six tires again with a flick of a switch without even leaving the cabin. It's been said to take less than 20 seconds. Now the 6x6 gets its power from a 5.5-litre twin-turbocharged V8, developing 544 horsepower and 760 Nm of torque. But weighing over a ton more than your average G, we can expect the performance figures to be somewhat different as well. But that said, it's not slow.
0 to 100 takes 7.8 seconds for a car that weighs nearly 4 tons and has 6 wheels.
That's still faster than a Golf 4 GTI, by nearly half a second.
Top speed is 160, and I personally would not want to go faster than that. It just wasn't made for that. It was made for everything else, for destroying dunes and driving through rivers and going everywhere, literally everywhere. The one thing Mercedes never really did give specific figures about was the fuel consumption. However, word has it that you normally cruising at about 30 liters per 100, or north of that, way north.
So, the 6x6 is not necessarily your daily driver, unless you lived in a desert, in Africa, or in both. And neither of these is the case today. So let's get those marshmallows and head back for dinner. Yes, you've spotted it. This is a Lamborghini SVJ, and we fitted it with one of our Novitec exhaust systems, which is why it is now probably one of the loudest cars in the world. And in case you're wondering what it has to do with grilling marshmallows, this video, feel free to like and subscribe and hit the reminder button so you can get notified every time we post a new film.